VR development is a bit different than normal game development. Especially with the Oculus Quest, you have to put on your headset in order to test your game. I will show you three ways how to debug in-game.
So one big problem with the Quest right now is that you can't really debug your game in the Unity editor because you can't connect the controllers to your PC or Mac. So you have to test your game while wearing the headset, which makes it difficult to debug. I'll show you some ways to work around these limitations and create some assets you can use in real time to debug your application.
One way to debug your application while it's running is to use the ADB, the Android Debug Bridge. It comes installed with the Unity Android SDK, so you can use it directly. The command we are looking for is loghead to show the device log while it's running. Now, if you just use loghead, you see all the logs from your Oculus Quest. So we don't want to see all the logs, we just want to see the logs regarding Unity. We can use the S parameter to filter just for Unity logs. If you put on your headset, you can see the logs directly streaming to your console. You can use this to see errors or warnings or debug output in real time, but you can also use this for your own purpose to display some own messages. So for example, if we want to display the destination of a teleport every time we have a valid teleportation target, we can do this by using the debug log message. And now if we hover over some valid targets, you can see in the console that it displays the destination. Another way to show debug information is directly in the game. For this, we can use the debug canvas prefab that comes with the Oculus package. Just drag and drop it to your scene. As the debug canvas is rendered in world space, you have to change the camera settings. So select your main camera, in this case that's the center camera. If you now add the debug UI sample script to, for example, your player controller, you can see a sample dialog directly in your game. To show it, press the menu button on your controller. You can even interact with the UI elements to change some settings in your game. Now to use it for our own purposes, we don't want to use the sample script which comes with the Oculus package. We want to create our own debug helper. To do this, we can create our own C# script and add it to the player controller instead of the sample script. If you double-click it now, it will open up in your favorite editor. The idea is that we use this as a singleton so that we can access it from wherever we want. To do this, we create a static property called instance of the same type of our script. And then if we implement the awake method, we can just assign this to the instance. If you want to get some ideas what you can do with the debug canvas, we can just open up the debug UI sample comes with the Unity package and take a look at the code there. You can see that there are some samples for adding controls or labels to the canvas. One important part is to enable or disable the menu with the menu button on your controller. To do the same thing in our script, we can just copy and paste the whole update method to our new script and add the in-menu boolean as well. The next thing we want to do is adding the possibility to change the log message in runtime. To do this, we can add a text property, which we can use to change the text every time we want to update the log message. In the start method, we can now use the debug UI builder from Unity to add a custom label to the canvas. The addLabel method returns a rectransform object, which we want to save for now. With this, we can use the getComponent function to get the text of the label and assign it to our log text. Now we can actually create our log method. We can add a parameter to send a log message. And then we can use our log text to change the text value every time this method is called. Now we can use our debug singleton from any point in code to show custom log messages. If you now run your game and press the menu button, you see our custom canvas. And every time we log something, the string is updated. The third way I want to show you is to use a free asset from the asset store. You can just search for Graphy and import this free asset to your project. This asset is super easy to set up. You can just drag and drop the Graphy prefab to your project. One problem is that it is set up for screen space rendering, but we can easily change this to world space and assign our center main camera. We can reset the position to zero and change the size and the scale to something smaller. In our debug script, we can now use the Graphy Manager to disable or enable the asset. As the graphic canvas is now rendered in world space, we have to change the position and the rotation of this canvas to match our OVR camera rig. To do this, we can get a reference to our camera rig by using the find method. Now every time we show the graphic canvas now, we can align the position and the rotation with our camera rig. To make it better readable, we should of course push it a few meters away from our position. We can do this by using the transform point function and providing a Z value of something like 3 or 4. If we now press the menu button, we can see the Graphy asset with some nice graphs and stats of our game running.